My name is Christian Molman. I'm a project member, a postdoc in the project Evaluating Evidence in Medicine based in Kent. I worked a lot on the so-called reference class problem, which is a very basic problem for all accounts to probability and causation. Suppose you go to the doctor and the doctor tells you because you have cancer, the probability of surviving for the next 5 years is 70%. How can a doctor make such a bold claim about you specifically? What he's doing there normally, he considers people that are similar to you with certain respect. For instance, he considers your tumor, how big is the tumor, what kind of structure has the tumor, and then he considers how many people in the class of all people that are similar to you with respect to the tumor, how many of those die. And if the number of those dying is 30%, then your probability of surviving is 70%. The problem with this is obviously there are several reference classes you might belong to. For instance, your genetic profile might be very specific, you might be doing a lot of sports, you might be religious. So the question is, what is the relevant reference class here that is relevant to you specifically? Evidence of mechanism can be a crucial role in deciding which of the reference classes is more relevant and which property is less relevant. It might constrain your causal theory about what's going on and therefore give you a better prediction for yourself or the specific case you're interested in. Check out a paper by myself and John Williamson. It's called Four Approaches to the Reference Class Problem. This gives you a very good overview about the approach. And then there is a more entertaining and fun piece in the law literature. It's called Is It a Crime to Belong to a Reference Class? Catchy title, catchy paper. Read this as well.